What is the most wholesome thing you have seen? Was headed to Oakland from San Francisco through the tube. Trains packed as always. People on BART are good about public transit etiquette in general during commute hours, so nobody's talking or listening to music or anything. When we leave the tube onto the viaduct over the port, one guy answers his phone. Hello? You there? Oh my god. What hospital? Okay, I'll be there as soon as I can. He hangs up and just looks super distraught. Someone taps him on the shoulder and says, my car is parked at West Oakland. Do you need a ride? He agrees and they get off together. Little gesture, but it was uplifting to see someone volunteer for a stranger like that. I had a teacher in high school who had a reputation as being the super tough mean. Older African-American lady. She taught health class. There was a mandatory CPR class that we had to pay for. And there was no way I could pay for anything in those days. CPR day came. And she told me to go with the other students. I gave her a confused look, to which she replied, you're a good baby, and she had paid for me. Later in the year, I fell asleep in her class. It was a home game day, basketball. And she told me to lay back down after the bell had rung. It was the last period of the day. She told me she'd wake me up before I had to report to the gym. She dimmed the lights and played some light jazz while she did her work at the computer. I hadn't been sleeping well at home and I'm guessing she knew. I woke up when she brought the lights back up and she handed me one of her cup of soups she had warmed up. We never really spoke much, but she had my back and I made sure she knew I had hers. The most wholesome. On senior night, they introduce the players and say some stuff about them as they walk to center court, typically with parents arm in arm. When it was almost my time to walk, she saw that I was alone. Bless her heart. She about fell down from her seat running towards me. She put her arm through mine and just looked forward. Chin up, proud as hell as they read my stats grades etc. I remember that walk and how I wish I had a picture or recording from that day showing how big I must have been smiling. My friends' mothers had tears in their eyes. They made sure to invite me to dinner with them after the game and I made sure it was okay that I brought my teacher. She politely declined and just told me she was proud of me. After I had graduated and was a bit better on my feet, I returned to visit her. It was honestly the only thing that could get me back in that place. Each time I'd bring flowers and or food and made sure to do it in front of students and made sure they knew to respect her. Only story so far that has made me tear up. If I had a gold, you'd get it. When I was a preschool teacher, we had one kid who was our certified cheer upper. If someone was crying, she'd get a tissue, walk over, carefully blot their eyes and make them blow their nose. All while saying, it's okay. You're okay. Eventually they'd stop crying. She'd take their hand and they'd go play. She was a little angel. Edit. Thank you for sharing all the super sweet stories in replies and for the silver. I was playing with my 6-year-old nephew and pretending to cry really dramatically. And I suddenly his 2-year-old brother yells, oh no. From the other room. Comes running and repeating oh no. As he runs. And starts patting my cheeks and dabbing at my eyes with his shirt saying you okay. Such a sweet kiddo. My last week of high school. Our lunch lady gave out small gifts to some of the seniors. Just the kids that took the time to chat with her that she got to know more personally. I received a sketchbook with a sweet good luck note in it. I was always in art club and was going to school for fine arts. So she took the time to get all of us a gift that was specific to us. This lady saw hundreds of kids a day and still took the effort to get to know us. Lunch ladies are the best. I bonded with one in my high school and she would always tell me about her day and was always excited to see me. She was like a really cool aunt. Lunch lady at my high school knew my name and my order. I was always impressed that she still took time to give what's probably a thankless job a little personal touch. A little boy at the airport kept trying to climb over a concrete divider that had active traffic on the other side. His mom was loaded with luggage and kept trying to stop him, but didn't have free hands. My brother-in-law walked up and said, hey kid, there's a rule here. You have to keep one foot on the ground at all times. Look around. Everyone has at least one foot on the ground. The kid kept trying to climb. But with one foot firmly glued to the ground, he wasn't in danger anymore. Such a creative and wholesome way to let the kid keep playing while keeping him safe. As a parent, drop the luggage and tell him you need his help and hand him a little bag so he feels needed and stays with you. Thank you for the silver. I don't know what to say other than I love you. A friend and I were talking and she said she'd in front of the kid of another friend. I dismissed it by saying A. She probably knows worse. We asked what was the worst word she knows. She very carefully looked around just in case her parents were around and whispered selfish. Jeez. I asked my 6-year-old son what was the worst word he knew. He responded that would probably be hunt. I was on what I call a rumpled suit flight. One of those flights on a Friday at 6 from NY to DC where most of the flight consists of business people in suits drinking $14 double whiskeys. A fellow rumpled suit sat across the aisle from me next to a mother and her kid. When she could, the kid brought down her tray table and a coloring book and started coloring. I didn't hear what was said, but at some point the kid handed the rumpled suit a coloring book and they spent the remainder of the flight coloring and chatting. I was kinda like, I want to color too. I was on a flight about a month ago and there was a kid next to me with a bunch of Pokemon cards. This was after Sword and Shield was announced, so I asked him if he was excited for the new game. His eyes lit up immediately and he started geeking out and showing me all his favorite Pokemon. I told him my favorite game was Emerald and he said he never got to play it. I have a GBA emulator on my phone with a ROM of it, so I let him play it the rest of the flight. The joy of a child is absolutely beautiful. I have two nieces. At little one's birthday, her friend gave her two unicorn toys. She immediately looks at Big Sis with a huge smile. Look, Big Sis. This one for you. We can both play. She was genuinely so excited to play unicorns with her sister and it never even occurred to her that Ditty didn't need to give one to her. My heart grew 3 sizes that day. A few years ago, I was on my way to catch the bus when a middle-aged woman called me from behind a newspaper stand. She pointed to the bus stop. One block down. Where a guy was standing holding something. She said he was her son. Who just got out of jail after serving time for dealing drugs. And today was his first day trying to make an honest life. He had baked some traditional pastries himself and was trying to sell it on the bus stop. And she wanted to make sure things went right for him on his first day so he would not feel tempted to go back on selling drugs. Then she put some money on my hand. Asked me if I could buy some pastry and obviously not tell him she was there. At the stop. I saw the guy. Probably in his mid-30s. With this little table of pastries. I bought 3. We chatted a little bit and 1 minute later my bus arrived and I left. It always makes me emotional and warm inside to think how pure a mother's love can be. When I was like 11. Dad was driving us to a gathering at my grandma's. There was a woman pulled over on the side of the road. Dad asked if they needed help. She said she'd run out of gas. Dad told her he would get some. So we go into a gas station. Dad explains the situation to the cashier and is prepared to buy a can of gas. There's this other customer that looks like a biker, big dude with tattoos and piercings. Who tells Dad he has gas at his house and tells us to get in our cars and follow him. His wife and young son were in the front yard. Turned out this was his sister's house. The guy had fled a hurricane with his family. Nevertheless, he insisted on giving us the gas for free. That's very kind. We ran out of fuel on a family holiday. But we weren't that far from the next town, so my dad gets a jerry can and starts walking. He returned with a full can in the back of a ute driven by some young men who had picked him up. Driven him to the service station and driven him back to us even though it was out of their way. I read a story once about a woman whose father had died before her wedding and his organs were donated. The man who received his heart walked her down the aisle. Yesterday at work, my boss' 5-year-old daughter was drawing a picture for me and said, "This is you. A princess." And I thought my heart would combust because that was just so sweet. She proceeded to make a little collection of drawings. which she folded into a book and gave it to me. It was all hearts and rainbows. That was just absolutely wholesome and made me appreciate little kids. Made my day, to be honest. At a concert, I saw a buddy walking with his friend who was blind and also somewhat physically disabled. I overheard him telling his blind friend, "Oh man, I was so smashed last night. I couldn't walk or see nothing. Thank God for you and your cane. You were steering us everywhere like a champ. I would have been helpless without you." It was really so heartwarming, and you could see how much it meant to his friend to be told how he was the helper, not the person being helped. I'm assuming he was being a little hyperbolic. But the amount of joy I saw brought to his friend's face from his kind words was so heartwarming. When I first had foster children placed with me after bedtime, my pit bull would go into each room and check on the kids and then sleep in the hallway. If any woke crying in the night, she would crawl into bed with them. Seeing my 4-year-old nephew share his peanut butter sandwich with his friend at the playground. Edit. Thank you, stranger, for my first gold. My oldest son. He was just getting to where he could sit up well and bend over, sit back up all on his own. My wife was in the shower. I had him on the bed. I noticed he started pulling at a pillow, so I pulled it over in front of him. He laid face down on it for a second. I thought, wow. He must be tired, and just before I grabbed him, he sat back up and smiled the biggest gummy grin ever. Then he did it again. And again. Then it suddenly hit me. He's playing peekaboo. So he did it another time, and when he sat up, I said peekaboo. And he laughed and smiled. I'm a fairly rigid guy that doesn't get emotional or worked up about much, but that broke me down and lifted my spirits all at the same time. Edit. Thanks for the silver. I had no idea this story about my son would blow up like it did. I gifted a used electric wheelchair to a family who couldn't afford one. The kid, maybe 14 years old, was kinda grumpy looking when he arrived. Didn't say much. Once we got him in the chair and he was zooming around, he was all smiles. His mother was also super happy. I heard the next day he told his sister to clear off the driveway so he could practice with it. And by the weekend he had gone to a fair. Edit. Bit more background. I had a nurse doing some care at the time. I got a new wheelchair and was looking for somewhere to donate my old one. She mentioned this kid she knew and made the arrangements. I was in the local supermarket doing my shopping. I was pushing my cart in the frozen food section when I came across a young woman in her 20s. I'm estimating. Her little girl, I think around 2 years old, was sitting in the cart she was pushing. She was beautifully cooing to her little girl. I love you. I love you. Among other sweet things and sounds. Now. I never met this young lady. I never talked to her. Just watched her treat her daughter very sweetly with all the love in the world. It was the most nicest thing to see and experience, because my own upbringing was a living hell. My parents broke up when I was young. Around 5-6 years old. Mother got custody of us kids and she was a mentally ill, abusive, psychotic monster. I never knew a scene like that in my own life. All I got from my mother is daily yelling, screaming, cursing, nagging, and hitting. On more than one occasion she told me to my face how she wished I was never born. I just knew. With a kind, loving mother like that in her life, that little girl was going to grow up into a nice, normal, happy human being. Having a mother like that makes all the difference in the world. One of the kids in my class was talking to one of our new kids. It came up in conversation that the new kid's shoes didn't fit and made his feet hurt. The boys also realized that they wear the same size shoes. The next day the OG kiddo comes in with a pair of Jordans he never wears for the new kid to have, and a note from his mom saying it was okay. It was one of the most precious things I've ever seen. Edit. Wow. My first gold. Thank you, kind stranger. Edit 2. They have the same size feet, but the new kid was wearing a size too small. It was confusing how I wrote it. Damn pregnancy brain. One Christmas season I saw a young woman, late teens or early 20s, walking through an IKEA picking up things in the huge marketplace area. taking a picture of them, putting them back, and moving on. She was obviously thinking intently about gifts, but I was confused. Was she making a wish list or something? An employee saw this and asked if they could help her find something. She says, "Oh, no thank you. I'm helping my dad Christmas shop. He works really hard and has very little time. Plus when he gets off work his brain is just fried. So every year when I'm on break I go around to a bunch of stores and take pictures of things I think my mom would really like. Then I'll show them to him at home. We talk about them and he picks some out. Then I go back and get them. It's the least I can do for him. Plus it's kinda become our little secret Christmas tradition. Mom has no idea."